A very good evening to all of you and welcome back to our channel The Teacher. And in this tutorial we will talk about how to create this seabird animation using the morph transition. So let's see the preview once again. And if I show you the thumbnail view by expanding that, and here you can see that only 3 slides has been used. And if I open the animation span by clicking on the animation tab, animation pan, then you can see that I have not applied a single animation on any of these 3 slides. And this bird has been drawn using the shape tool. And if you want more information about how to use the shape tool, then you can watch my playlist on using Microsoft Word drawing tools. So the same technique and same commands are used in PowerPoint as well. You can see that the shapes menu of PowerPoint 2016 or 2019 is similar to one of the Microsoft Word shape tools, and you can find the similar drawing tool settings and other commands in all the Microsoft applications. So if I go to the PowerPoint and select this one of these object, then you can see that a shape format menu will appear here, and if you click, then you can find all these commands here. And if you go to Microsoft Word and draw a shape here, and after selecting this shape, the same shape format menu will appear. So the commands are similar, so you can go and learn that from the shape tool playlist. So here I'm going to close this animation pan. And before we dig into the tutorial, let me tell you that this animation is inspired from one of the animation at dribble.com, and that animation is by Brooke Candelora. Maybe I spelled it right. So here we are back into the PowerPoint, and if you see the first slide and we go to the transition tab, then you can notice that I have not applied the morph transition on the first slide, and we are advancing to the next slide in 0 seconds because we don't want this bird to stay in the air for even a minor second. So that is why this slide will only be visible for a very short duration, a tenth of the second. So on the second slide we have applied the morph transition with the duration of this transition is 0.75 seconds. And again we are advancing to the third slide in 0 seconds. So that means this slide will appear for 1.75 seconds until the morph transition will end. And as soon as this transition will end, it will advance to the next slide. That is the third slide. And on the third slide, we also apply the same morph transition with 0.75 duration. And we are again advancing to the next slide. So we don't have any next slide here, but we want to make the loop of this animation, and for that you can go to the slideshow and click setup slideshow and make a check mark on loop until escape, loop continuously until escape. Hit the OK key, and if you will see the slideshow, then it will make a loop of this animation. So you can see that at the first you see the first slide, then the wings go down and again it moves back to the first slide with a morph transition of 0.75 seconds. So press the escape key to go back. So here are a few things that I need to tell you. And if I go to the home tab and click the select drop down button and open the selection pan, then you can see all the objects that I have used to draw this seabird. And after creating this bird on the first slide, what you have to do, you have to expand this thumbnail view and right click on first slide and choose duplicate slide. On the second slide, what you have to do, you have to flip these wings to down. So to flip this wing to down on the second slide, what you have to do, you have to move to the shape format tab, and here you have to note down the width and height of this object, and the width is 2.57 and height is 1.65. so what you have to do, you have to hold down this shape from this handler and drop it downwards. And the size should be exactly the same. So here I am going to stop this right here, and it is showing the red guides, which is indicating that this size is similar to the top wing. But if I drop it right here, then you can see that the size is 1.48 and we need 1.65. So you have to change it manually and press the enter key. And we will do the same with the second wing, and here I am going to drag it down. And the size is 2.55 and height is 1.48. So here I am going to change the height manually. So on the second slide, go to the transition tab, click the morph transition and change the duration of this transition to 0.75 and make a check mark on after and uncheck the on mouse click and set this timing to 0 seconds. And here on the second slide, you also have to move the body to a little bit up. And again, I'm going to replicate the first slide by right clicking on it and choose duplicate slide and move it below to the third slide. So we have this first slide, and then this one will be the second, and that will be the third. So on the third slide, again apply the morph transition, set the duration to 0.75 seconds and make a check mark on after and set the timing to 0 seconds. So if I hide these fourth and fifth slide, which are the older one, by right clicking on them and choose hide slide, and you can select more than one slides by holding the control key, hide slides, and let me show you the preview again. So I think I need to move the body a little bit more up so the second wing will not show up. Let's see the preview again. So I hope you will find this tutorial useful. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks for watching and have a great day.